Hello. So today I finally want to record, start to finish, the issues I'm having with my ChatGPT Plus subscription. It seems to be an issue that is not well documented. Many people are either not aware of it or don't want it to be true, or are trolling or astroturfing or gaslighting you when you point this out. So I want to go from start to finish and show exactly what the issue and what the injustice is, right? So I have a normal ChatGPT Plus account, which is 20 USD. It's not really 20 USD, but we'll get to that. I can use the servers, you know, for like an hour and a half, 2 hours, maybe 2.5 if I'm lucky per day, which means I'll get one cycle of messages, okay? Ever since the introduction of GPT-4o, my account, and I assume many others, has been absolutely crippled and limited. First of all, GPT-4o and GPT-4 are not identical in performance, right? I literally benchmark this shit. I keep track of all the calculations, of all the results, and so on and so forth. Don't get me wrong. Either way, that's not the point. It's a very capable model. It's a very impressive model, right? But they're not identical in terms of performance. Absolutely not. And the issue is that I'm constantly, even for my tiny amount of usage, constantly getting kicked out and saying like, oh, you can't use it anymore. Try again in 3 hours or whatever. But I need to use it now. That's what I paid for, right? Okay, so let me tell you exactly what's going on. So, right? First, you need to look. What is my plan? Well, it's GPT Plus. It just says access to GPT 4, 4.0, and so on. So let's actually see what the marketing material promises. What is GPT Plus? This is the official website, the official data that they represent if and before you purchase, right? I can also refresh in case you're saying, oh, it's outdated, or you manipulated the HTML or whatever. I've heard it all. Let's reload the page. Let me just also see the current time. So today is Monday, May 20. This is like, I think this is where OpenAI is, and this is me. So what is GPT Plus and so on? That's all fine and good. But then if we come to the usage limits, the latest update here states Plus users will be able to send 80 messages every 3 hours on GPT-4o and 40 messages every 3 hours on GPT-4, right? There's, of course, a caveat where it says if it's under extreme load, they may, in certain cases, may dynamically adjust, right? The thing is, that's not in certain cases in may, that's always, permanently for me, 100% of the time, it's reduced, okay? So I counted manually my messages as I was using the map, and the first time I noticed this extremely was when I got kicked out after just merely 4 messages. That's 4, F-O-U-R, 4, out of this 40. And I was like, what? This must be some kind of bug, right? Or they're extremely underload, or whatever. So the next day, I was kicked out after, I believe it was 20 or 25 messages. And I was like, this is not right. Anyway, I contacted support, which by the way, is just a chatbot that always says the same thing, like clear your cookies and your cache. It's always identical, right? So I reported a bug here. I said, you know, after 4 messages, I got my limit. And then it's just saying, oh, you should be able to get 40 and everything, right? And please confirm, gaslighting you against, you are doing the error and so on. It's just a generic troubleshooting message. I rated this as, you know, bad. Then I set the exact time zones when I used my stuff. I said exactly which models I used and that I double, triple checked. I said exactly the timestamps in time zones and so on. I said I had a video. I posted screenshots. I posted time caps, everything. Oh, it could be due to a bug or a temporary glitch or a system outage. Please see our system status page. I checked the status page. It says all systems operational. It was all in green, right? It still says that. And basically, they're asking the same stuff I already provided, so I never gave feedback again. Hello, just a quick reminder. Have you found a solution? And so on. I said, obviously, no. I mean, it's useless, right? They didn't look into the issue, nothing. I mean, I guess they get swamped by support. I get it. I absolutely do get it, okay? But still, this is completely useless and pointless. It doesn't do anything except for introduce more rage. Okay, so let's actually now, and I will do this on the record, go into my account. And I haven't used this for, I don't know, 2-3 hours or something like that. I was completely locked out of GPT-4 once again after just merely, I think it was 10 messages. So let me actually go here into my settings and use, where is data control? Let's actually export my data right now. It will send me all my data. This is, I think, I don't know if the Americans can do this too, but essentially in Europe, as per GDPR, which is the Data Protection Rights Act, you can export your own data. So I'm going to do this. Should receive an email. So you see it's all up to date. It's the new stuff. I'm not making anything up. This is on the record. So let's look for, let's see if I get the mail. There's the mail. Just received. Download data export. Okay, let me see. It's on my other screen. Where is it? Let me bring this over. I'll have to do some editing here to hide my you know, personal data. But okay, so this is the data I just received with all your data, user data, message data, feedback data, conversions, and so on. So, and this is what you get, right? Just a bunch of jumbled mess. So let me actually run a JSON viewer plugin to like format this a little bit. And then here's all my data, right? Which is not very helpful because they don't even give you timestamps. They give you like Unix time codes or whatever. But as you can see, this is sorted by date, right? Chronologically. So the newest will be at the top. That's, you can test it out. That's always how it is. And that correlates with my timeline here, right? Mabel Odds Calculator Program. Hold up, where is it here? Mabel Odds Calculator. So there is the time stamp. Let me actually use the update time stamp. Okay. Epoch Time Converter. Let me see what actual time this is. So this was in my time zone at 15:27 or... Okay, this was like 2 hours ago. Let me see what the next update time is. Oops, sorry. Update time. Well, there's creation time. Okay, so this is the second message. Okay, the last reset was at 16:47, I believe, right? Okay, so anyway, you can download your data, and you can look at all the models you use. I think they call it like model slug or something like that, right? Model slug. So you can see which models you use. In that case, that was a GPT-4o. I also have some GPT-4s here where I got locked out. This was the last time where I got locked out. GPT-4. This is the last and first GPT-4 message. So let's see if there's a timestamp here. Create time. There it is. 1452. Right. So that's roughly when I got locked out, where it said you can only use it at 1637 or 6047. Sorry. Okay. So now let's see. So you get 80 messages for GPT-4.0 and 40 messages for GPT-4. The status is all operational. There's no heavy load. There's no outage. There's nothing. Now let me actually see. I have also I've compiled everything in here for now. So this is my subscription. This is my credit card subscription, which is €22.63, which equals to $24.59. It's due to taxes, right? And due to currency conversion, right? So it's not $20. It's more like $25. And this is the advertised messages, so 80 for that, 40 for that. So if you would get half, right, you'd get a value of 1230. We don't know that yet, though. So let me actually go into a completely fresh new interface here and go to GPT-4. I will now fast forward as I just type in the messages until I get locked out. Okay, so you have reached your limit for GPT-4. The limit resets at 8:25 p.m. So this is in 2 hours, 2¾ of an hour. So that was 25 messages. Let me actually remove both of this. 25, okay. 25 messages. You will receive 40 hours, and the load is all operational, nothing. Okay. Let's go to GPT-4.0. Again, I will fast forward so you don't have to sit through this boring mess. Okay, 25, you've reached your GPT-4.0 limit. Responses will use your 3.5, 8:25. After 25 messages, 25. Okay, once again, 25, guys. They advertise this with 80 messages and then 40 for GPT-4, which is 120 total. And I got this time 50, which actually is quite higher than I usually get. 50 out of 120. And the status says everything is up to date. Or like everything is running well and there's no huge load or anything like that. You can see, like, no incidents. This is this feels like fraud, like absolute fraud, like scam, like absolutely. There used to be in the UI, when you clicked on here, there used to be right there how much the limit is. Right. So you had an overview. Okay, now it's like super busy, so I get a little bit less, right? So you could kind of like see, okay, I can like time my work on this, right? But they removed it. They went out of the way to remove it, like because it was there. Now it's removed. And they don't give you any indication, A, how many messages you have, B, why your message limit gets lowered, and C, like how much you've used up. You have to do this stupid counting shit where you have to go into your JSON files and time-consumingly convert Unix timestamps and so on in order to even get a clue of how much you're getting screwed over. Right? Like, this is unbelievable. This is unbelievable. And I don't understand how people are okay with this and gaslight you and say like, oh, you don't need to count to towards 26 or something. I've seen people on Reddit literally do that. And guys, listen, not everyone is using this for gigantic, enormous code work, right? Where you say like, oh, I use this 12 hours every day and I never hit my limit. Yeah, no shit. But there's many different use cases, right? Some people just want to talk to their GPT, whatever, do small things or do many things. It doesn't matter what they use it for, right? Because Plus users will be able to send 80 messages and 44 GPT-4. And whatever they want to use it on, whether it be voice interactions or small snippets or vision help or whatever, should be none of your concern, right? As you can see, I just showed you that this is, and I have history of this every single day, right? But now I have it in recording once more. I also have it from my last time. This is not okay. This is not okay. Like, this is at best, right? Scummy, and at worst, flat out illegal. I'm furious. I am absolutely furious. And you're like, oh, well, what do you care? Like, there must be so many people who are getting screwed out, right? And I get it, right? A lot of people use this service, okay? But then they should be open about it. They shouldn't type this. They should type, how long does it take to edit this message? Like 5 seconds, right? Current limit is 25. Bam. Right? Or something like that. This just feels sneaky, scummy, disgusting, honestly. And like, you feel like an absolute schmuck, right? Obviously, I canceled my plan because, like, I'm not willingly getting scammed. And this is systemic. Like, this is all day, every day on my account. I have contacted support. They don't do anything except copy-paste troubleshooting messages. Oh, did you check our status page? Maybe there's a bug or whatever. No, this happens on every browser at any time of the day, every time. Unbelievable. This is unbelievable. Okay, well, I'm just ranting now, but like, guys, and do you think I get half my subscription money back? Good luck with that. Hell yeah. This is unbelievable.